How many times you said you will finish something today and you didn't? How many times you regretted something that it took much longer than expected? How many times do you see a frustrated PhD student? Well, if you ask me, I see many, a lot of times. So today's video is about how do I stop procrastinate, how do I be more productive, how do I get through my PhD in the most easy way possible. In other words, how do I remain focused? I'm watching a lot of videos online and I see PhD students being frustrated, working long hours, lose interest, making even videos about their how much frustrated they are and keep on going like that. And I wonder why. Well, perhaps I was one of them. Maybe I wasn't. The truth is that you don't have to be like this. Of course, the supervisor and the PhD itself, it matters a lot. Just remember, you are not alone in this journey. You have a supervisor. If you want to know more about how to choose the right supervisor, I've got another video for you. This video is more about how to plan some activities, how to have more discipline in what you're doing, enjoy and execute. First things first, one of the most important things is that you like what you're doing. Right? So just ask yourself, do you like what you're doing? A PhD is not just getting a degree, you're getting a title, as we said many times, and you need to make sure that you get it through a journey that you like. It's something that interests you, you put a lot of effort, and you own that thing. So that is out of the question. So the next thing is that you need to be pretty realistic with your plan, meaning that first of all, you have a plan. It is very often when we set unrealistic targets and we don't meet them, so then the whole thing is postponed more and more and more. More things are accumulated, more ideas, they get on top of each other. You can't manage the PhD, and then is when you struggle. So make a realistic plan, put some milestones and some realistic deadlines and try to meet them. So be disciplined. It's not about how quick you will make things, it's whether you will last doing the same thing over and over again, meeting one deadline after the other. In other words, I don't mind if the deadline is 2 days later or 2 days before. What it matters to me is to have a realistic deadline that you can meet. Next thing is, as Jeff Bezos said, to categorize things in the fun stuff and not so fun stuff. So a lot of times you realize that you really enjoy doing something. Maybe that is a very repetitive stuff, maybe it's very interesting, something that you do a research on, or maybe writing a paper, or maybe writing a grant. Different people that have different ways of having fun, right? But there are things that you need to do for your PhD that are not so much fun. And just make sure that you do categorize these two and you play with them accordingly. Spread them over your diary, and make sure that you put the not so fun stuff in the morning. For most of the people, it works much better when you have just wake up, you have your stamina, you have energy to do things that you are not so interested in and maybe you don't have too much fun with. So you can do them. Sometimes it doesn't even think that it's such a big thing. As you get along in the day, you will see that you get tired, you get accumulated tiredness, and you feel a bit more down because you keep on working. So those times you better put things that they make your life easier, they make you more happy. Just to give you an example, I'm recording this video at 10 p.m. in the night. So I've had a very long day. I woke up at 7, at 8 o'clock I started working. I had my meetings, I saw my students, I saw my colleagues, I've read papers, I gave feedback, I've written a part of a grant. Now that is like almost close to a day, now I'm recording this video because I'm just having fun though having recorded those videos. So let's clarify that. Things that you enjoy a lot, that you have fun doing, just put them later in the day. With things that they need you to be concentrated, focused, maybe you don't understand them well and you need to be really, really focused at 100%, just put them in the morning or midday. Now, another thing that you have to have in mind is that there are tasks that they require much energy and they take much longer, and some others that they are much smaller, shorter times can do the job. So I've heard a lot of people saying that I'm breaking my day in 20 minutes or 10 minutes or 5 minutes tasks. it cannot be done for everything. Some tasks require you much more concentrated time to be there. In fact, after a certain time, you even function better. So my advice here is just make sure that you only work on one big task at a time. Maybe that time is half a day, or a day, or a couple of days, maybe it's a week. So make sure that you're only working on that and everything else is put aside. In my work, it works like day stuff. Every single day, I have a big thing that I need to finish that day or maybe to make a huge progress with, and everything else comes around it. Everything else can be 30 to 45 minutes concentration time, or a meeting, or a kind of a slot where you meet others and you discuss things. And these can be squeezed, if need be, in different days. It's absolutely easy to manage those. The big thing though, it's got a deadline and you have to meet it. You better meet it, because otherwise, as we said before, you will accumulate things, you will become more stressed, you become more discouraged, and you won't want to see your PhD anymore. Make time for yourself. Maybe you have a very stressed day, maybe you're working 8, 10, 12, 14 hours, some people working 16, 18 hours a day. Make sure that every couple of hours you have some time off to de-stress yourself. Go out if you want, have a walk. Just don't think about the work anymore. You need that. You need that in order to be able to come back and start from fresh again. While I was doing my PhD, many, many times I felt that I couldn't solve something. And the easiest way to get around that, it was just to go out, leave it for some time, maybe come back to something else, and next day look at it again with a fresh eye. That helped me move on and get over these kind of problems. In this way, you will not really procrastinate something, because you're making progress in other things at the same time, while you're giving time for chewing the information, processing the information, and come back with another perspective and look at it again. The next comment is pretty interesting, because a lot of students, they just realize that after they finish their degrees, and that applies to undergraduate, postgraduate, PhD students, especially if you haven't worked in practice in the industry, you don't really know how to cost yourself. So what I'm saying to my students is just be expensive, as if you are costing a lot of money, and now that you're working for yourself, you're working for your PhD, you're costing a lot of money to yourself. Because instead of actually being out there and working for a company and most probably making more money, you're working for a PhD where you just make a small stipend. If you realize how much you cost yourself, maybe you will be more productive. It's very often when our students, they get out in the industry in the second, in the third year, then they come back to continue their studies and they just realize how much they can do in the 8-9 hours of a day. Because they set the deadlines, they meet the deadlines, and they're very productive. Whereas if you haven't done that, you're just procrastinating. Always you're procrastinating. The time is never a lot for you. Now, there are some complex things, and in order to reach at the point where you will be focused enough to solve those complex problems, you need to be tuned in the problem for some time. If that happens and you're close to evening and you are thinking of leaving, I would advise you perhaps to consider keep going. So when I was doing my PhD, I liked the quote, "Whatever I can finish today, I will not leave it for tomorrow." If you reach at that point where you have all the information fresh and you're just working on something, don't just let it for tomorrow. You better spend some more time on that day and get tomorrow off. Don't even come at the university. Relax, go to the gym, go out, see your friends, do whatever you want. In this way, you will feel not only more productive, but you can feel that you manage yourself and you have this superpower where you can work a lot if need be for completing a task. That is a skill that will pay you a lot in the future. Find what works for you. Studying, learning is a very personal thing. Even in academia, what we're trying to do is most of the times to make the degrees and the educational system as rounded as possible, so we actually include everyone who's learning with different styles. So personalize it to yourself. Don't hear what a YouTuber may tell you. Don't hear anything around. Just get some information, but you make your own studying environment. Find what do you like. Find your pace. Set up your environment. Feel more comfortable, more productive, and stick to that. And no matter what you do, never forget what is the main aim. And the aim is not just to get a PhD. The aim is to develop something that you're proud of. The aim is to learn and process that information. Learn something that you really like, process it, and give it another dimension. That is your aim. So always think that and try to decode what you're reading and what you're writing and what you're processing, and find the main reason for doing that. Once you find that reason and you have it clear in your mind why you're doing this PhD, then you'll be pretty happy of what you're doing. People are procrastinating because they forget their dream, they forget what they're going to do, they forget what they're trying to achieve, and they just feel that this is another job. So let me find something better to do in that time, and that leads to procrastination and procrastination and procrastination. As I've mentioned in another video of mine, meet your supervisor as often as possible. The supervisor is there to put you back on track, to tell you what is important and what is not important, to tell you who are the people that you're competing with and what they're doing and what you should be doing. So the supervisor is dragging you back to the main focus, and that means that you will get the soonest route to your aim. And the closest that you get to your aim, the less the procrastination will be. You will realize that very soon. So although some exploration around alone is nice, it's good to have a guide and be back on track. As you may have realized in my videos, I'm proposing a few software that I'm not associated with any of them, and I don't feel myself being the guru of apps and softwares that when it comes to collaborating and sharing information. However, there are some software that they will make a huge difference to your everyday life as a PhD student. One of these that I'm strongly recommending to everyone, including the PhD students, is Notion. So Notion is a software where you can have a profile for the project and you can share that with your supervisor, and you can put there all the tasks. And every single time that you're crossing out a task, you tick a box, that will help a lot both of you keep tracking your progress. It will give you more incentive of actually doing the job and completing the job, because it's nice to see it crossed out. I'm sure there are other software as well, but that works really nicely, really well, and I definitely recommend it for those that don't want to have this kind of motive of doing the job, completing tasks, and moving on without procrastination. So these were my quick comments. No matter what you do, stay positive, stay tuned, stay focused, try to be as productive as possible, have realistic deadlines, and try to meet those deadlines 1, 2, 3 days a week, 2 weeks later. It won't make a huge change. What it will make a change is if you have a deadline and you miss it. But other than that, see what works for you, personalize your style, and stick to that. Please don't forget to like the video and subscribe if you haven't done already. Thank you very much for watching. Until next time.